My name is Laura Calçada. I come from Barcelona, and tonight I'm going to talk to you about socially engaged art. Back in January, when I was thinking which community to focus on, I knew that art was going to be there. And then Simon Dove introduced me to socially engaged art, and that fascinates me because it is a form of art that connects art and social change. The artist gets out of the studio practice, the isolation of the studio practice, and co-creates with the community, empowers the community. As Simon Dove put it, it's a moving away from the artist who is the great master, who can illuminate the world with his genius, to the artist who is someone who catalyzes community action. Here we have Immigrant Movement International in Corona, Queens, New York. It is a community center that started out as an art project by artist, Cuban artist Tania Bruguera. Bruguera is known by her concept of arte útil, useful art, which combines practical and creative skills. What happened in this community center? In this community center, they provide social services and with also art and activism. I went up to Corona, to Queens, just to check it out and see about their activities, and I engaged in a couple of classes, of dance classes. I don't know if there are Colombians. There is a Colombian over there. It was Bullerengue and Mapale, two dances. It was a very enriching afternoon, and I could see how they serve the community up there in Queens. How I continued listening and learning about the social engaged art world. I spoke with 26 stakeholders, and I attended 13 events, and that was really inspiring because all the people in this community are very knowledgeable on this topic. What I discovered is that the social engaged art community needs funding that comes from grants, fellowships, and so forth. And they also lack recognition because a lot of people are still skeptical of the power of art to really enact change. And then I saw there is ego. At the end of the day, they are artists and there are some egos. So a lot of projects that I saw, some similar projects that they could join forces and really, you know, work together. They need that a little bit more of collaboration to really impact. What else? What I did? Then I wrote stories. I wrote stories to inform and to connect socially engaged artists with institutions like the Queens Museum, which is a museum that is leading the way, spearheading the change on what a public museum, what is the role of a public museum in our society. Then I also was, I published in Hyperallergic. That was a great experience. Hyperallergic is an awesome publication on the arts with a very loyal audience. What is the success of Hyperallergic? It started like a little blog, and now they are very respected. Hyperallergic serves a community. They have a passion, and they have an expertise. And that's basically this big success of Hyperallergic. They are focused very well, and they do very well what they do. We go to engagement. One of the stories had over 1,400 likes on Instagram. Another one had 1,200 views. But then again, we are social journalists, and we've been talking a lot about engagement. And this, the metric that really, that I feel really, really important, is the qualitative one: quality over quantity. And here you can see a couple of comments of two artists, Renee and Ronnie, that I've been following their work throughout the year. And you know, when you see these comments or hear a comment of a teacher, a professor, thank you for your bravery. I've been able to share your story with so many of my undocumented students. Students, this is a story on Maria de Los Angeles. She's an artist and a DACA recipient. This really make me feel, you know, your work has an influence. It's helping people, and with the artists, helping them, taking pictures in their events. And Ronnie really liked that little video I did. So yeah, the qualitative impact, it's important. And now we arrive at the local Crown Heights. This center, I wanna talk to you about this center in Crown Heights, Brooklyn, my neighborhood. There is this storefront space that is rented out by a church. You're gonna say, what is this, the relationship? You're gonna discover it soon. The relationship is that this church wanted to engage with a broader community of Crown Heights. And here is when I stepped in, because you know, it's near my place, 2 minutes walking. So what is this? Cultivate Brooklyn arts, education, culture. Says yes, and we wanna engage with the community. We want them to know that we are here. So, I helped tailor a survey focusing on the assets of the community, on what they could offer, what were their needs, and how their assets could help their neighbors. Then I led this survey effort, and we ended up talking with 108 neighbors. We used three strategies, and you know, very basic, very simple. It's a listening post. I sit down in front of the center and I went through the survey in a conversational way with the neighbors, and they could tell me their needs, and it was really beautiful way to engage with the community in Crown Heights. We also set up an event with a community group, SOS, Save Our Streets, the youngs in Bed-Stuy and Crown Heights, and they did the survey. I find out that going one-on-one and to talk to them, it was also the way to really get the information, because in a big group, the guys were more quiet. And we also visit seniors at a senior center. So we went and we talked with all the neighbors in this way. What are the most important lessons I learned? Well, cooperate with the different institutions in the neighborhood is key. Like, the cooperation, and also that people value honesty and transparency. They are gonna be really eager to collaborate with you and with your reporting if they understand the value of what you're doing. little video, you see some of the neighbors of Crown Heights.
Amazing. Dynamic and vibrant. It's pretty safe.
Mountain
pop
for all races.
Fun, enjoying, and loving it.
Full
of life.
Humans are the beautiful place.
Lively.
It's a growing community.
Tolerant and diverse.
We've got Pacific, Caribbean, Americans.
Good people. Into a neighborhood.
Crown Heights is becoming one nation.
So yeah, I collect all these surveys, then I engage with a very useful tool for journalists, Excel. We sometimes don't like it, but we need it. And we need it very much. And what I discovered is that yes, the community wanted a space, a free space, where basically these are the three main things that they would like to do in that space. After school programming, focus on mentoring, engage in arts and cultural activity, they said singing, drawing. The elders talk about writing their stories. The kids talk a lot about music. And then a space of community building. Talk about the problems that arise home and also issues of in the community. So these were the three main uses that they would give to that space. What is the next step? Because the next step is to share all this knowledge, all this information with the neighborhood institutions, including the Brooklyn Museum, because as a public museum, maybe we can reproduce something similar what the Queens Museum did with that first example that I showed you at the beginning, Immigrant Movement International, and eventually Cultivate Brooklyn will become its own non-profit organization. What happened? What happened with this project? What did I learn? Well, some of the basics of social journalism. Before starting anything, I know that everybody here is pretty much knows about social journalism. So, but yeah, before starting any venture, just listen to the community. Just listen. Don't start. If these people in the church, when we are gonna set up a yoga, I arrived 9 minutes. I didn't thought about that. A yoga, and how do you know if they want a yoga class? You have to ask your community. Then cooperate with the different institutions on your neighborhood and the key leaders. That's heavy. And then know their basic language so you understand where they are coming from, and then collaborate, let your audience collaborate with your reporting by including them, and by respecting them, you'll gain their trust, but really including them. It's just not about the quote or about that story. It's about creating, sustaining, developing a relationship. And finally, the only thing I hope to have instilled in all of you tonight is the importance of conversation, and that art is alive, and it's a wonderful tool to empower our communities and to foster individual thinking. Thank you.